myself Shipra Burua. So I am talking about lesson 15. It's a social studies subject for class 5. Okay, now I'm explaining this lesson. Lesson is 15 lesson. 15th lesson is precaution for natural disaster. Okay, now natural disaster to cope with natural measure to cope with natural disasters. Although many natural disasters cannot be predicted, predicted many suitable measures can be taken to lessen the impact of these disasters. Some of them are the following. Better knowledge about these natural disasters can at least reduce the extent of damage. And second point, its people in the disaster-prone area can be more vigilant and get prepared for face them in a better way, so that their ill effects are reduced. So, and the third point is immediate help from the national and the international agencies can prove very helpful for the affected people. Now, suitable measure to cope with the earthquake. First one is an early warning to an earthquake can help people to evacuate their home and other buildings to minimize risk of life. And second one, if one is indoor, he should not run outside but move under tables and beds. And third one is, one should keep away from windows, mirror and things that could break and fall. Okay, now to minimize the loss, earthquake resistant buildings should be constructed. Existing building may be strengthened structurally. Okay, look at this scene. It is a scene of an earthquake. If the possible of the in the earthquake prone areas, the houses should be made of wood. It would be better if the fall of such building or do not touch the ground. So, as was done by the ancient Japanese in building their temples. Last but not least, one should not panic but try to remain calm. So, ways of minimize the risk posed. Most volcanic eruptions give a warning, so proper steps should be taken. If different disaster response activities are taken in time, like effective warning and carefully planning, measured loss and all these things. So, now by adopting such method, much loss of life and properties can be minimized. As an example, sir, when Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines erupted in June 1991. After 6 centuries, the deaths were limited to 350, only though its eruption was one of the largest in the 20th century. So, by careful monitoring of the precautionary. So, ways to minimize risk to pose to landslide, the hazard posed by both landslides, avalanches can be minimized to some extent by avoiding construction of building on steep slopes. And if constructed works are more essential, then certain building codes must be followed. Okay. So, measure to minimize the destroys, disastrous affect the tropical cyclone. In such cyclones prone areas, human settlement should not be too close sea coast. Early warning by the authorities can help people evacuate such low lying areas, which would be hit hard, and daily TV weather reports should be telecast, and self shelter should be built by the government, and proper arrangement to providing all necessities of life, and people should not be allowed to go near the seashores. And now, ways to cope the drought. How to, in drought prone areas, water harvesting structures should be constructed and conserve rain water. There are then on the spot where it rains, so stored water could be used in time to need. So small dams should be constructed to store water in sufficient quantities. You can see it's a drought area. Okay, and afforestation or planting of trees should be undertaken to conserve rain water. You know that. And the drought resistant crop should be developed, which could be grown dry conditions. Too much dependence of agriculture on animals and husbandry should be avoided by the livelihood. And farmers should be encouraged to join seeds. So flood preparations or control of floods, how can its proper arrangement should be made in advance of evacuating peoples to safer place, and if proper warning is given to the peoples, many lives and properties can be saved. And to check the flood entrance, central part of the village and towns, proper embankment should be made, and for those people who are still caught in flood, flood and water supply should be dropped to them by helicopters. Okay, so now here you can see the flood areas. Okay, now here the topic is finished. So thank you.